Leading up to this game, he's got a very good KDA, 14.5. In this matchup, Forgiven realizing they could turn around, now they're on tabs, and here comes Shook.
This is a great bait though. Shook's going to come in, and Limited almost certainly will be the first blood, but who will take it? It will be Shook.
Yeah, very, very well played. Shook was in the right, the looks of it. Can he explode them?
He goes in, gets the explosive cast, catches Shook out, but immediately takes the lantern from Niff.
That was fate. Niff was able to just react and realize, hey, if I get knocked towards the tower, I'm fine. Young Bucks now being dove.
Young Bucks already used his ultimate, and Wicked's trying to take advantage of that one. Pots a big burst down onto Young Buck.
No, Forgiven's only got a Vamp Scepter right now. And I'm happy you pointed that teleport out in the top lane, because it's not available for the dragon fight. Forgiven's going to be dove here by Froggen.
Zap lands on towards him. Spear is back up, and he's just going to pounce in Google form. Comes on towards him. The claws come out, and Froggen gets a kill.
Almost missing it, but it works out himself that way. Now Young Buck is going to try to defend the tower. He's caught Wicked a little bit.
He's managed to chomp down on towards him. Subjugate has been used. He's going, Wicked's going to run away from this one. Young Buck's going to try and catch out, but it's off.
Tabs continuing throwing out. That's a cast just to clear the minion wave and a great lantern out. Tower should go down shortly.
Oh, Tabs is tanking this one completely out.
He's down!
And the rocket comes in. He was kind of asking for that one. He took about 3 tower hits.
Force Alliance into team fights. Right now, Alliance are looking for a pick.
The dragon fight is a possibility. Amazing goes in, but he's gone a bit too deep, and Shook just wrecks him where he stands. All the help of Tabs. Tabs off of the side. The Pillar of Ice is actually doing him a great defensive favor. Youngbuck flashes in, doesn't realize the tower's still there, and suddenly has to back away, and the wolves, well, they find themselves in trouble.
Started to count on what wants to steal.
The last one was stolen away, but not going to happen this time around. Shook just gets blown away.
Youngbuck from the side, but he might be a little late.
He's a little late to the party, and while he does manage to land the Pillar of Ice, the rest of the wolves are coming in. They want to try and pincer someone off. They're going to throw out the barrels. The lantern is there. Shook's not going to take it. Unlimited gets caught out completely. He just gets dropped where he stands. Now Amazing's in trouble. Kaltar's getting locked up around the side. He's having to run for his life. But Shook comes in. He's trying to sink those fangs in. Has he got the damage? Youngbuck goes down to Froggen. And the Copenhagen Wolves are just floundering right now. It's Alliance in full control. And they're going for Baron.
That was a perfect workout for them this time around. Alliance grab 2 kills. They grab a Baron. And now they've got a commanding lead in the game to their own jungle. And it's just very, very good play.
Oh, the spear from Froggen nearly taking down Kaltar, which is why he's not able to shove those wave out. You just saw him down the bottom lane. We see Wicked's going to quickly counter that one. Explosive cast used on Niff, but it's not really going to catch anything out. And they could turn this one back around. Spear lands on Unlimited. The Copenhagen Wolves are running scared once again. Another spear comes in. This time it's on Amazing. Death sentence on towards Youngbuck. Youngbuck, the tankiest member of the team. He's just getting drilled down. Amazing takes one for the team. Has to kick Shook away. Niff's going to continue chasing the hook.
The hook
gain on Kaltar. This time around, he's not going to get away. And Alliance are pouncing on the Wolves.
And because of the damage and the rest of the Wolves, Alliance are going to get their turret and the inhibitor for this one. That was a very, very good play.
Great turnaround. Alliance pushing on there. And again, it's Niff creating the plays for Alliance. And the Copenhagen Wolves are...
No. I think somebody tanked it.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure somebody tanked
it. I think Froggen took it. Took it to the face and just carry on all these Piltover traps, just keeping them at bay, and slowly but surely that turret is going down. There was the explosive cask. It did next to nothing. They're going deep. They get the Timbers down there. Tabs is going to be the focus, but then Nil can't get him down. You can see Youngbuck, he's going in. He gets hooked up by Niff. Shook's taken pretty low. This is not a bad turnaround. Forgiven's trying to put the damage down, but again, just not enough.
All of the damage was not on the carries. It was Wicked and Shook that was focused down. Look at that ace in the hole. Now Alliance on the turret.
That's the AD carry taking a single ability there from the opposition, and he just can't face it. They've got super minions coming in. They're still Wicked, causing all sorts of problems for Youngbuck. He hasn't even popped that Banshee's Veil yet. He just keeps hammering away on him with that club. Forgiven is back now. They are going to keep this tower safe for now.
So the wave clear is pretty good from Kaltar. He's able to at least delay this, but look at the life regen for Tabs, plus the heal from Froggen. There's already back up to full HP, and Alliance are just going to keep doing this one. The inhibitor is still standing in the mid lane.
With that rocket down from Forgiven, it means they're going to go for it. Amazing tries to go in there, but well, the death sentence has just pulled him straight in. Timbers comes out, does next to nothing. The spear's continuing to flow from Froggen. The tower will be beaten down. We do see Wicked coming in around the side. That's just absolute destruction. Kaltar didn't even know what hit him there. Forgiven gets annihilated, and Alliance are just going to push on through and take this game. It was a 5-game win. A run in the Copenhagen Wolves have had such control in their game. And again, you've got to give credit. The top lane, Wicked, won out that lane fair and square.
That just helped him win. His lanes was doing it for them. You know, Wicked did well in the top lane, Tabs and Niff did well in their bottom lane. And it was just an all-round very good performance from Alliance.
Yeah, 0-2-2 for the Lee Sin this time around.